Yeah. Oops. Yes. Nope. Yes. Need a light. There we go. Happy Thursday, everybody. Happy birthday to Trent Reznor. It's tough to write stuff like this. And the thing is, it took two people to write this. Trent Reznor is 47 today. He doesn't do a lot of albums, but he spends a lot of time working on movie scores and soundtracks. So in that sense, he is our generation's Danny Elfman. Perhaps. Cheers. I wonder if this will get matched as third-party content. Of course, we can have birth without death, and today we learned that Donna Summer had died. And I've been very bummed about that, and I spent 4 hours listening to Donna Summer. And the thing is, obviously I'm not immune to it, that you enjoy someone and they're a personal hero of yours, and yet today was the first time in 2012 I've listened to any Donna Summer. I know this because I fastidiously log everything that I listen to in Last.fm. And Last.fm says the last time I listened to Donna Summer before today, I think I got it somewhere. No. I take that back. I listened to a Paul Jabara with Donna Summer duet. Does that count? That was March 16th. But before that, December 30th, last year, when I listened to Winter Melody. And that was probably just because my iPod had shuffled it up, which is how I got the Paul Jabara. So today I listened to 4.5 hours of the Ultimate Collection and felt sad. Because of the song, doesn't it? I haven't seen this movie yet either. I hear that if I watch it, I will want to punch everyone in it in the face. Is that true? I gotta show off my Twins jersey, just in case Amy's watching 2 days in a row. Yesterday she took me to task for talking so much about hockey and basketball and not about baseball at all. And there's a couple reasons for that. Basketball and hockey are in playoffs and exciting. And the Twins are quickly looking up their record. Like 10 and 30 something. And I'm a bandwagon fan. Twins are 12 and 26. So it's hard to get excited about them. Although they're only 10 games out of first place. Because the Indians are really not running away with it just yet. So we can still turn it around. On the other hand, the Wild were at one point the top team in the NHL. And they finished pretty close to dead last, I think. So, fortunes can go up and down. But the playoffs have been where it's at. How about those playoffs last night, by the way? How about that game-ending 8-0 run by the Thunder? I'm not surprised the Thunder had a run like that. A couple of times at the Target Center, the Timberwolves had a good lead on the Thunder, only to see it just kind of slip away where they suddenly couldn't make a shot in the world, got a run, ended up winning, and it was just annoying. Although, when they do it against the Lakers, as opposed to doing it against the Timberwolves, it's delightful. But they got really lucky. Steve Blake should have drained that three. And I know there's all this talk about, what was he thinking? Why didn't they go to Kobe? Why didn't Kobe close it out? Kobe's got no clutch, blah, 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 blah. And the truth is, Kobe was not nearly as open as Steve Blake was, totally wide open. And the guy who was supposed to be covering him was too busy staring at Kobe. And two steps off, and Blake had an open shot, and he really should have made it. But he didn't. And they lost. And I'm very happy about that. So, Thunder are up 2-0. Now, you're supposed to win at home. We'll have to see what happens at L.A. And again, that's got a back-to-back, Friday and Saturday. And that's going to be muy interesante. The Lakers can't win on Friday. I don't know how they can win on Saturday. So maybe a sweep. But I'm getting ahead of myself. Had a comment from... Oh no, it was from Doug, and it was about hockey. It wasn't about basketball. So, I won't say anything about the Spurs surely destroying the Clippers tonight, but we'll wait for that to happen. Where is it? Here it is. Let's go Rangers. Yes. Ooh, they blew it yesterday, though, didn't they? They were in good shape, and then somehow the Devils kind of came back, and then they kind of went ahead, and then they kind of stayed ahead. And it was kind of not as much fun to watch. I found myself flipping to basketball. That's all I have about hockey. That's really all I have about sports. I have not been watching the Twins. I haven't been to the Target Center since it opened. Just keep doing this. I like this, though. It's baggy in the right places. Makes me look really athletic. Yeah, right. It's the way I walk. Really bummed about Donna Summer. I didn't know she had cancer. Cancer sucks. But all day long, I wanted to post videos of Donna Summer songs. I only did one, but I was so tempted to do other ones. And again, it's like, why haven't I been listening to her more? I've just been listening to other stuff. There's all sorts of stuff we'll listen to. But I'm sure that she will get back into the rotation. I mean, you have to be in kind of a mood to hear some of her stuff. And, you know, she did have a life before disco and after disco. The before disco stuff, you really have to be in the mood for that kind of bubblegummy folk rock stuff that Georgia was doing in the early 70s, which I love, but you have to be in the mood for it. And when I'm in the mood for it, I usually just go straight to Georgia instead of listening to Donna Summer. That's my problem. And then the stuff after the disco, it's like, it's okay, but it's not great, but it's okay. And it just never pops into your head that, like, wow, this is an album I really should be listening to right now. So I've got plenty of albums here in the iTunes library. Stuff that I bought and have digitized, and some fine 12-inch collections, including one Jane bought for me, which was so nice for her. It was a birthday gift. I mentioned Jane because she kind of freaked out after the Rangers lost, and I know that at her house, where Kim is staying, there's probably 3 or 4 people screaming at any one time during that game. And it's probably very exciting, and yet I'm glad to be home at my home alone when that's going on, because that might be too much for me. Have I bored you enough? Well, let me do one more from Trent. See if I can really get into trouble. Actually, this one matches. Maybe I won't. Maybe I should sing it. I need a piano. She shines in a world full of ugliness. She matters when everything is meaningless. Fragile, she doesn't see her beauty. She tries to get away. Sometimes it's just that nothing seems worth saving. I can't watch her slip away. I won't let you fall apart. I won't let you fall apart. I won't let you fall apart. I won't let you one note too low. She reads the minds of all the people as they pass her by, hoping someone can see. If I could fix myself, I... But it's too late for me. I won't let you fall apart. I won't let you fall apart. I won't let you fall apart. I won't let you fall apart.